The boys are back in town. The ritual begins. As usual, the city mayor leaves his lookout to make a stand. But today is different. His rival means business. The warlord has had a shock. He needs time to regroup and bolts for his tree. From the sidelines, the troop can only watch and wait. The tables have turned. The noose tightens. With the city mail trapped, the outlaws fall into position. Their leader makes his move. Game over. There's a winner. And a loser. The warlord is out of action. Nearby, the Sisterhood seem confused and anxious as the strangers start to infiltrate their cozy world. After the heat of the battle, a lull. But the outlaw males have only one thing on their mind. Females. And the females know what's coming next. This is what the males have been fighting for. Mothers huddle to protect their babies. As the conqueror displays his power for all to see. Inferior females can only submit to the gang male's wishes, but those of a higher rank are more assertive and stand their ground. Desperation gives the females incredible courage, but size and strength are not on their side, and the outlaws have nothing to lose and everything to gain. They've waited all their lives for this moment, and it may not come again. It's the chance to mate and father the next generation. The females protest in vain. Meanwhile, the leader of the gang has claimed the lookout tree. Power is at last within his grasp. Well out of reach, the warlord nurses his wounds. He's a shadow of his former self.